Sometimes as a character building exercise, you're going to look at not just one special triangle, but a pair of them in combination with each other, or even more than two triangles. You might have a whole bunch of them arranged together. And the purpose of this is just to give you some more exercise with your special angles and help you memorize the relationships between the sides. So in this example, I have a 45-45 triangle over here, and it's kind of stuck on the end of a 30-60-90 triangle right here. And I'm asked to find a relationship between these two sides. In this form, it's saying, hey, if I give you E, can you figure out what D is? And there's all sorts of arrangements that are possible, so I don't know if this is going to be exactly what you're looking at, but the methods that I use here will be similar. And what I want to talk about is just a quick reminder of the relationships between the sides. When you have a 45-degree triangle, like on the left here, remember that as you multiply from the side to the hypotenuse, you're multiplying by radical 2. And as you go from the hypotenuse to the side, you're dividing by radical 2. Okay? So that one's pretty simple. The 30-60-90 is a little more complicated, but not by much. You just go by a straight multiplication of 2 when you're going from the short side to the hypotenuse. Or if you're going from the short side to the medium side, you're going to multiply by radical 3. And if you're going from the hypotenuse down to one of the sides, that's a little more complicated. You have to multiply by radical 3 over 2. And you can see that in the lengths of these sides and what their ratios are. So using that information, and go ahead and pause the screen here if you need some time to figure that out. But if using that information, I want to go through a few steps here to work my way from E over to D somehow. So let's start with E. And what is that? That is 3 radical 3 on this side. Well, remember, it's a 30-60-90. So how could we get to either the medium side or the short side using the hypotenuse? I prefer going to the short side because that's very easy. You just divide by 2. So this is going to be 3 radical 3 over 2. And now we can go to that medium side. So first I went over here, and now I'm going to go over here to the medium-like side. And remember, that's just multiplying the short side by radical 3. So if I multiply this short side, 3 radical 3 over 2, by another radical 3, that gives me 3 times 3 over 2. Or, in other words, we could simplify that a little bit and just call that 9 over 2. And now as you multiply from the medium, from this short side of the 45-degree triangle to its hypotenuse, that part's easy. That's just multiplying by radical 2. Okay, so this is going to be 9 radical 2 over 2. Okay, so just quick review of what happened there. Let's put some more labels on these sides. Some people like seeing a whole lot of labels on here. That helps. I can say A equals E over 2. Okay, so in other words, 3 radical 3 over 2. I can say B equals A times radical 3. So that's 3 radical 3 over 2 times radical 3, which gives me 9 over 2. And then the last step would be saying D equals radical 2 times B, which is just 9 radical 2 over 2. Okay? Now, my answer ended up rationalized, this answer right here. I did not have any rationals on the denominator. But if you do have rationals on the denominator, don't worry about it. I know that in polite company, you want your radicals on the top, but don't worry about it. Just get the trig right.